So to start this, you're going to want to open up a web browser and type in Ultimaker Cura. We need to download the Cura software from the Ultimaker site. When you get to their site, click on the download for free icon here. And then select do not share any information, simply because the information they want you to share is very lengthy. Then click download. And after that downloads, you want to go to your downloads folder, wherever that's saved. Open the file and run the install procedure. On a Mac, you just click and drag it to the applications folder. Now open the applications folder and find Ultimaker Cura. It has a blue C icon. There it is. On a Mac, you want to right click and then click open for when you're opening it for the first time. And then click open again. Sometimes it takes a little bit upon its first startup, but you're going to want to click understand and agree. Now we're going to want to add the printers. For the larger CR-10s that we have, you click other. Scroll down and find CR-10s. And then select add printer. For the smaller all black printers that we have on the bottom shelves, you're going to want to go up here and click that and then add printer and select other, and then scroll down and find Prusa i3. It has the same build size and similar parameters. Select add printer. Now we need to get the custom profiles that I made so you don't have any printing problems. So go to your browser and type in this link. The end of it has to be all capitals. So make sure it's all caps, otherwise it will take you to a different link. Once that opens, you're going to want to click on Cura Printing Profiles. And then right-click the CR-10s profile and download it. And do the same thing with the Makerselect profile. Right-click and select download. After those have downloaded, we can go back to Cura and import them. So go back and open Cura. And then there, you're going to want to select Manage Printers, select Profiles, and then on the right, you're going to want to select Import, locate your Downloads folder, and select the CR-10s profile, select Open, and we're going to want to do the same thing with the Makerselect profile. Now you can select Close to open a file for printing. You're going to want to select the open folder on the left, locate the STL file which you'd like to down print, and open it. We'll automatically place it on the bed. Final thing we need to do is select the correct profile we just imported. So click Find there, and then down select Custom. Under the profile, we're going to select whichever printer you're using here. So we're going to select the Makerselect because we're using the smaller printers. If your part does need support, you have to go down and click support and turn it on. By default, it is turned off. Click Generate Support. Now you can slice your model for printing. Now we can save it to the SD card. So when you put your SD card in, it will pop up and say Save to Removable Drive. Select that, automatically save it to the SD card. One thing that is beneficial is if we delete all the other files on the SD card, that way it's easier to select it on the actual printer. So if you open up the SD card, find all the files that aren't the one you just made, and delete them. It'll save you a ton of hassle at the printer.